Namo Amitabha Buddha. So in my previous video, someone commented, "Are you saying that we can just do whatever we want in this life, good and bad? And at the time of death, we just chant the name of Amitabha Buddha so we can gain rebirth?" Well, first of all, I definitely did not say that we can just do whatever we want, good and bad, and just chant the name of Amitabha Buddha, then we can gain rebirth. If it's been misunderstood that way, then my apology. It's probably because I had not explained it so clearly. So what happens is, yes, Amitabha Buddha has infinite compassion in that he will receive all beings, including the people who have done bad deeds. But what happens is that even for such people, at the time of their death, they need to be repentant and they need to believe in Amitabha Buddha. Even though this person may not be able to say anything at the time of death, but still, these kind of thoughts need to be in his mind, and he need to believe in Amitabha Buddha and actually want to gain rebirth to Amitabha Buddha's pure light. In that way, Amitabha Buddha will come and receive him. So if you don't want to gain rebirth to pure light, if you don't believe in Amitabha Buddha, and you feel no repentance of your wrongdoings, then you will not resonate with Amitabha Buddha's energy, and you will not be able to gain rebirth to the pure land. So Amitabha Buddha definitely doesn't want us to go around and do all the bad deeds and just chant his name to gain rebirth. This would not be Buddha's wish. This would not resonate with Buddha's heart. What Buddha wants is all people to do good, to cultivate good deeds. However, even for those who have done wrong, but if they realize this, even at the time of their death, they have this kind of one thought of repentance, then Amitabha Buddha will still come and receive them. So in the Infinite Life Sutra, Sakyamuni Buddha told us about three levels of rebirth. And in the Visualization Sutra or the Contemplation Sutra, Sakyamuni Buddha further divided these three levels into nine levels. So within each three levels, there are also three more levels. So we have the upper level of superior rebirth, upper level of middle rebirth, upper level of lower rebirth, middle level of superior rebirth, middle level of middle rebirth, middle level of lower rebirth, and the lower level of superior rebirth, lower level of middle rebirth, lower level of lower rebirth. So all these nine levels represent our karma, our cultivation in this life. Because when we gain rebirth, we have not transcended our karma. So in a way, we bring our karma with us when we go to the pure land. So this karma is reflected in the nine levels of rebirth. And for the people who can gain upper level of superior rebirth, what you need to do is to have deep belief in Amitabha Buddha. You have this pure heart, you have this deep belief without doubt, and also you have bodhicitta. So what is bodhicitta? So this is a bodhisattva path. So the bodhicitta means that you have the heart to obtain enlightenment for the benefit of all sentient beings. So we don't just go to the pure land to enjoy pleasures for our own selfish desire. Of course not. We go there to realize enlightenment, to become a Buddha, so we can better help all beings in all different worlds, or come back to earth to help all beings. So we need to have a big heart, this bodhicitta heart, this desire to obtain enlightenment for the benefit of all beings. Because we have this big heart, so of course we will cultivate good conduct and we'll carry out all the precepts and do good deeds in our life, so we can obtain upper level of rebirth. And for the beings who is able to gain middle level of rebirth, they also have bodhicitta, but it's not as strong as the people with the upper level. For the upper level bodhicitta, it's really they resonate so well with the Buddha's vow and Bodhisattva's vow that we are here to help all beings, that we desire to gain rebirth to the pure land in order to help all beings. So they have this big heart, this big wish that they want to help all beings liberate from all sufferings in life, and this resonates with Buddha's vows. But for the people who gain middle level of rebirth, they probably don't have such a big heart. It doesn't mean that they don't want to help others, but perhaps they want to focus on their own liberation first. So they don't think too much about helping others. Also, they probably can't cultivate so much good deeds like the people who gain upper level of rebirth, but still they are a good person in general. And if they practice Buddhism, they are a good Buddhist. They observe the precepts, they carry out conduct in accordance to the moral principles principles. So the people who are able to gain middle level of rebirth, they need to be a good person in general. So for the beings who gain lower level rebirth, okay, this are the beings who has done all the bad deeds in this world. They're destined to fall into the three evil paths, the animal realm, the ghost realm, and the hell realm, most likely to the hell realm. But Amitabha Buddha has infinite compassion for all beings, even for these people who have done really, really bad deeds in this life. If at a time of death, if someone tell them about Amitabha Buddha, telling them that Amitabha Buddha could save them, if they are willing to believe this, and they're also repentant, they have this heart of repentance of what they have done, even for 10 recitations, Amitabha Buddha will still come to receive them. You know, for us humans, we are not perfect, and we have probably all done bad deeds in our life. If we are repentant about bad conduct, and if we believe in Amitabha Buddha, we are still able to gain rebirth to the Pure Land. And for all the beings who gain rebirth to the Pure Land, doesn't matter who you are, you will obtain a high level of enlightenment almost very quickly when you arrive in the Pure Land. This is also the vow of Amitabha Buddha, and that is why this Pure Land Buddhism, this practice is so privileged, because we are actually relying on Amitabha Buddha's infinite merits, infinite good deeds, and we will be taught under Amitabha Buddha on the high levels of Bodhisattva such as Guan Yin, Bodhisattva Avalokiteshvara, and Bodhisattva Mahasamaprabha, and other high level of enlightened beings. That's why we are able to obtain enlightenment so quickly, and not just any level of enlightenment, but a high level of enlightenment to the state of non-regression, which means we will not fall back no matter what happens. And we have the ability to travel to all different worlds to teach Dharma. So that is why it's so good to obtain rebirth to the Pure Land. Even for those people who are enlightened in this world, they should also obtain rebirth to the Pure Land in order to realize the ultimate level of enlightenment, that is Buddhahood. I wish you obtain infinite light and infinite life in this life. Namo Amitabha Buddha. Namo Amitabha Buddha.